Come on, everybody, wherever you are. Come on, clap your hands. The presence of our God is in this place. Hallelujah. All right, here we go.
The presence of the Lord is here.
I feel it in the atmosphere.
The presence of the Lord is here. The presence of the Lord is here.
Clap. Let's take it up one time. Oh my. Come on, the Spirit of the Lord.
The Spirit of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is here.
I feel it in the atmosphere.
I feel it in the atmosphere. The Spirit of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is here.
Clap those hands. Clap. Let's go one more time. Come on. Come on, the power of the Lord. Come on.
The power of the Lord is here.
I feel it in the atmosphere. The power of. Come on. Everybody blow the trumpet. Here we go.
Everybody blow the trumpet and sound the alarm.
Come on, Zion. Because the Lord is in this temple.
Because the Lord is in the temple.
Let everybody bow. So let all the people praise God
now.
Come on, let's go up again. All right, we're going to do it in harmony. A blessing from the Lord.
A blessing from the Lord is here. A blessing from the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere. A blessing from the Lord is here. A blessing from the Lord is here.
All right. Everybody.
Everybody blow the trumpet and sound the alarm.
Come on, Zion. Blow the trumpet and sound the alarm.
Because the Lord is in the temple, let everybody bow.
We bow and worship to you, God. So let all the people
praise
God now. Here we go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on, Tennis.
The presence of the Lord.
And I'm gonna get my blessing. Altos, here's your part.
I can feel the presence of the Lord. And I'm gonna get my blessing.
Sopranos, here's your part.
I can feel the presence of the Lord. And I'm gonna get my blessing.
Everybody say.
I can feel the presence of the Lord. And I'm gonna get my blessing.
Come on, let's go up.
Right now, I can feel the presence of the Lord, and I'm gonna get my blessing. Right now, I can feel the presence of the Lord.
Can we go up again? Come on, let's take it up one more time.
Right now, I can feel the presence of the Lord, and I'm gonna get my blessing. Right now, I can feel the presence of the Lord, and I'm gonna
let's walk
get
back
my
down.
Blessing. Right now.
Cast your cares on him. He'll open up a window and pour you out a blessing. Cause when the Lord steps in, he brings everything you need. Healing, power, and victory. So it's all up to you. Whatever you need, got to do. Trust God, believe God. By faith you will receive. I can
feel the presence of the Lord. And I'm gonna get my blessing right now. I can feel the presence of the Lord.
Let's go, come on.
Right now, I can feel the presence of the Lord, and I'm
sounds good.
The presence of the Lord, and I'm gonna get
everybody, everybody say, I can feel, feel. Oh,
the
yes.
presence of the Lord, and I'm gonna get my blessing.
We welcome you today to the Metropolitan Community Church of Washington, D.C. on this Memorial Day weekend. We celebrate Memorial Day in the United States to remember those who have given their lives in service to the country. And we also invite you around the world to consider this a time to remember those who have impacted your life and touched your lives in various ways. We are so grateful that our God is a God of memory. God of holy memory. If it's your first time to worship at MCCDC, my name's Dwayne, the senior pastor, and it is my honor to welcome you. So glad that you're here. I'd love to hear from you. My email is revdwayne@mccdc.com. A little bit about worship at MCCDC. First of all, we're here to worship God, the God who created the universe and the God who calls us to fullness of life. We're also here to connect as community, to know that we're not alone, that we have each other as part of a global community. We pray for each other. We're also here to offer spiritual resources, tools that we can use to live a faithful life in the midst of this world. Later in the service, we'll be offering Holy Communion, and we invite you to participate with us. You don't need to be a member, and feel free to use whatever you have available to join with us during that time. We also encourage you to light a candle or something else to connect you to worship, to create a small altar. Again, we're so grateful that you're with us today.
And good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you find yourself. My name is Kathy Alexander. I'm the associate pastor, and I also want to add my voice of welcome. Thank you so much for worshiping with your MCCDC family on this Memorial Day weekend. If you would like to have prayer, our pastoral care ministers would love to be in prayer for you. Go to mccdc.com and click on the prayer box and enter your prayer requests there, and it will make its way to our pastoral care ministers. We are a praying and believing community of faith. We have many opportunities to connect. You might have seen on the upcoming weekly video before service, as well as go to mccdc.com and take a look at the calendar of events, and I'll let you know what's happening and how to connect. Welcome to this service.
Our theme is bring heaven to earth, and that is our call, and that is our aspiration, and every day we work towards that. So I invite us to join together now in the opening invitation to bring heaven on earth. Reverend Kathy will offer the call, and I invite you to join me in the response.
Oh God, what do you require of us?
To do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with our God.
Know what Jesus taught about participation in the realm of God.
Love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, and all your strength, and love your neighbor as yourself.
God, help us to be true to our calling to follow Christ. You have given us so many gifts and blessings. Help us to be stewards of your abundance.
You have blessed us to be blessings.
Teach us how to live as blessings in the midst of fear. Teach us to embrace the mysteries of your graceful paradoxes.
The way down is up.
To be low is to be high.
The broken heart is the healing heart.
The penitent spirit is the rejoicing heart.
The repenting soul is the victorious soul.
That to have nothing is to possess all.
That to bear the cross is to wear the crown.
That to give is to receive.
That the valley is the place of vision.
Let us find your light in our shadows.
Your life in our death.
Your joy in our sorrow.
Your grace in our sin.
Your glory in our gloom.
Your blessings through all our days. Amen. Amen.
And for our opening hymn, we're going to sing, God, You Have Set Us, number 372, and you will find the words in your worship program.
Service, we'll let us go to God of our understanding in prayer on this Memorial Day weekend. God of our memories, God of spirits who are with you, God of defenders of our faith, God of our protectors, God of those who gave their lives for this country. God, thank you for those that we remember, those who we memorialize. God, thank you for those who live and give a life of service. God, thank you for those who are left behind to remember, to honor. Be in our hearts, O God. Be in our spirits, O God. Help us to rise up and to continue to have strength to protect those who are powerless, those who are voiceless, those who are in need of justice. Help us to rise up, O God, and be present with those who are in need of friendship, in need of a smile. Help us to rise up, O God, and live the life that you would have us to lead in service to you and in service to humanity. Help us, O God, to rise up and serve. And as we do, help us to give you the glory, give you the praise, give you the power of our spirits, O God, the power of our voices, the power of our signs. Thank you, God. We pray these things in the precious and most holy name of you, our God. Amen.
Thank you, thank you, thank you for the many ways that you're helping MCCDC to grow into becoming a generous community in so many ways. You give through your time, your prayers. I'm finding that each of you are teaching me what it means to give. We're teaching each other what it means to give with a sense of joy, growing together. There are many ways to give at MCCDC, by being involved in the community, by praying. The financial gifts are also a wonderful gift, and we thank you for that. You'll see on your screen that there is a QR code that you can Put your phone over that and give that way. Also, text message through our website or through the mail. We're so thankful again for the many ways that we're learning that our God is a giving God who invites us to give with creativity and with joy. And now we have a special testimony on the joy of giving.
Good morning, everyone. So I was asked to share my thoughts on giving. So here you go. I was fortunate enough to grow up in an environment that giving was just something that you did. And when you talk about giving, I want you to understand that giving is not just monetary giving. It could be giving of time, talent, or resources, that kind of thing. So to let you know more of what I'm talking about, I'll give you an example of when I was younger. Anytime somebody came into my grandma's house, the first thing she would say to them is, "Are you hungry? Have you eaten?" And that was just her norm. She wanted to make sure that anybody coming in had their necessities met. And that was one way she could do that. She always had food in the house. She always had food usually on the stove or in the refrigerator cooking. She had 12 children and was used to always taking care of folks. So she would always ask anytime anybody came in if she could help meet those needs. Now, I know you, if you're a member or if you're a frequent attender and you watch our services online every week, you see that we give an opportunity for those to give. But what I love about MCCDC is the fact that we do, yes, we make known what we need, but we never do it in a way that implies that if you don't give or you're not able to give, that there's any guilt involved. We know that everyone is in a different financial state, and some can give more than others. Some can only give a little. And it doesn't really matter what the gift is. It's the gift and the willingness to give. So I would encourage you, as you think about giving, it may not be money, it may be time, it may be something that you can offer to the congregation as a whole. It may be your gift of song, it may be your gift of reading ability, it may be the gift of going to plant flowers. It could be lots of different things. But always understand that the gift comes from the heart, and that's what we're looking for. Have a great day.
Come on, everybody, clap your hands. Come on. This one of them toe tappers.
To be praised.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you're worthy. Hallelujah, we praise your name. Hallelujah, so worthy. Hallelujah,
Lord, we live.
Lord, we live.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you're worthy.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, we praise your name.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, so worthy.
Lord, we live.
Hallelujah. Lord, we lift you up. Hallelujah, you're worthy.
Come on, sopranos, that's your part. Come on, sopranos.
Say thank you. You are a generous God, and you invite us to be a part of your generosity in this world. Thank you, God, for all of those who share their time and their gifts in so many ways, for those who offer their financial resources, that we might help bring love into this neighborhood and beyond. We praise you, and again we say thank you. Amen.
Good morning, my MCCDC family. Today's scripture reading comes from Psalms 127, and it will be the first egalitarian translation. If the Lord doesn't build the house, the builders work in vain. If the Lord doesn't guard the city, the sentries watch in vain. In vain you get up early and go late to rest, sweating to make a living. Because God loves us and provides for us even while we sleep. Children are the heritage God gives us. Our descendants are our rewards. Having children when you are young is like equipping an archer with wonderful new arrows. Happy are those who have filled their quivers with such arrows when they argue with their enemies at the city gate. No one will be able to make them feel ashamed. The next scripture reading comes from the book of Matthew, Chapter 7, verses 24 through 28. And once again, it is the first egalitarian translation. Anyone who hears my words and puts them into practice is like the sage who built the house on rock. When the rainy season sets in, the torrents came and the winds blew and buffeted the house. it didn't collapse because it had been set solidly on rock. Anyone who hears my words but does not put them into practice is like the fool who built a house on sandy ground. The rains fell, the torrents came, the winds blew and lashed against the house, and it collapsed and was completely ruined. Jesus finished speaking and left the crowds spellbound at his teachings, because he taught with authority that was unlike the religious leaders, the religious scholars.
Like a foolish dreamer trying to build a highway to the sky, all my hopes come tumbling down, and I never knew just why, until today when you pulled away the clouds that hung like curtains on my eyes. Well, I was blind all those wasted years, and I thought I was so wise, but then you took me by surprise, like waking up from the longest dream. How real it seemed until your love broke through. I was lost in a fantasy that blinded me until your love broke through. All my life I've been searching for that crazy missing part, and with one touch you just rolled away the stone that held my heart. And now I see that the answer was easy, as just asking you in. And I'm so sure I could never doubt your gentle touch again. It's like the power of the wind, like waking up from the longest dream. How real it seemed until your love broke through. I was lost in a fantasy that blinded me until your love broke through, like waking up from the longest dream. How real it seemed until your love broke through. I was lost in a fantasy that blinded me until your love broke through.
The resurrection of Jesus is a call to action. And for these 8 weeks of Eastertide and beyond, we have been looking at the call to action from Jesus from the Sermon on the Mount. The call to action is to bring heaven to earth. Yes, even in this world, to bring heaven to earth. To bring heaven around us, and to bring heaven within us. The Sermon on the Mount ends with a story from Jesus that asks a question. The question is, how are we building our lives? With this closing story, it's like Jesus is saying, if you remember nothing else from the sermon, remember this. He tells the story of two people. One is a wise person. This wise one builds their house on a rock. And then the rains come. Not just ordinary rains, but those sideways rains that turn your umbrella inside out. And the winds blew and the rain came. And the house did not collapse because it was set solidly on rock. The next person is described as the foolish person. They built their house on the first place they could find. They didn't test the soil. They didn't do anything. They just built the house. They built it on sandy ground. And the rains came. And again, it was not just ordinary rain. It was that sideways blowing rain that turns umbrellas inside out. And the house collapsed. It was completely ruined. Jesus draws on his Jewish heritage in telling this story. In ancient Jewish teachings, the house was a metaphor for the soul. And so Jesus is asking the question, how are we building our lives when it comes to our soul? Proverbs 14:11 from the wisdom tradition says, the house of the wicked is destroyed, but the tent of the upright flourishes. Jesus is inviting us to build our lives in a way that we are grounded, to build our lives in a way that we flourish. Jesus is saying, if you remember nothing else from the Sermon on the Mount, remember this, build your lives on that which is solid. Build your lives on strong foundation. When Jesus talks in the Sermon on the Mount about the treasure within us, the heaven within us, Jesus is talking about our focus, our desires, our priorities, the interior foundation. Jesus is inviting us to build an interior foundation that is solid and that will hold true no matter what kind of storms we experience in our lives. If you remember nothing else, Jesus says, remember this. So what kind of foundations are we looking at here? What kind of values? The reality is that we could spend days going through the Sermon on the Mount with all kinds of approaches to strong foundations. I'd like to look at two foundations. First of all, the foundation of trust. In the Sermon on the Mount, in Matthew 6:34, Jesus is saying, don't worry. Instead, Jesus says, build your life on trust. Trust in God. Trust in the creator of the universe, the heavens and the earth. Jesus says, give your entire attention to what God is doing right now. And don't get worked up about what may or may not happen tomorrow. God will help you deal with whatever hard things come up when the time comes. What Jesus says about worry is not as simple as it seems. We are actually biologically trained to worry. Our ancestors needed to be wired in this way so that they would run from lions and survive. So we are hardwired to be in survival mode most of the time. Some folks call it lizard brain. Lizards need a brain that makes them react to run from the hawk about to claw them up and eat them. So we have lizard brains that see the world as a constant threat. Our brains are so trained that we jump even when a hawk is not clawing at us. We even perceive false threats. Our mind automatically goes to worst case scenarios. We try not to think about our worries. We try to release our worries, but that doesn't work. It seems like the more we try not to think about these things, the more we think about them. So what to do? The invitation is to retrain our lizard brain to heaven on earth brain, to focus our attention on Jesus' thoughts, to be on the lookout for how God is showing up in our lives and to take note of it. God shows up throughout our lives every single day, and sometimes we're so consumed with our lizard brains that we don't even see what God is doing. The invitation of Jesus is to look to the sky, to look to the birds of the air, to look to the flowers of the fields, and therein to find ourselves in a more peaceful place. Be on the lookout for how God is showing up in your life and take note of it. Don't worry about the future. God will help us deal with what shows up. When whatever it is shows up, at that moment when we need immediate wisdom, God will help us to respond not with lizard brain, but with heaven on earth brain. The Holy Spirit oftentimes shows up in so many ways, and sometimes it's the voice of Jesus who walks with us and talks with us. What a friend we have in Jesus. We sing that song, and sometimes Jesus comes to us as a friend at the exact moment, if we get quiet enough to listen. Perhaps Jesus will say something to us like this: "My beloved, I have your back. I'm with you. I know this is a tough time, but you're not going through it alone. I am going to help you every moment of the way. Take a breath. Breathe with me. I'm breathing with you. Do you know how loved you are? I love you so much, so come to me when you're tired, when you're anxious, and I will help you. I have come, my friend, that you might have life and have it more abundantly. An abundant life is life beyond worry." It's Jesus saying to you at this moment, this day. For a clue, look at the Sermon on the Mount and then get quiet and see what particular message Jesus may have for you to help you bring heaven to earth, not only around you, but especially at this moment within you, that on the inside we can find a quiet and strong place. Build your life on the foundation of trust. Another of several foundations is the foundation of beloved community. For Jesus, life is not life without community. And in fact, just as science has pointed out lizard brain, science has also looked at the importance of relationships. Science has shown that one marker of those who live the longest lives is meaningful relationships. You want to live longer? Well, a healthy diet and good exercise are helpful. And relationships are even more of a factor. Community is life-giving. And in community, we bring heaven among us. We have the ancient community of our ancestors, the psalmists and the prophets. The psalmist in Psalm 127 speaks about this foundational house that we're called to build. The psalmist writes, "If the Lord doesn't build the house, the builders work in vain. If the Lord doesn't guard the city, the sentries watch in vain. In vain you get up early and go late to rest, sweating to make a living. Because God loves us and provides for us even while we sleep." This idea of living lives that are foundationally built on the solid rock of solid values is an ancient concept, and one for today as well. To draw on beloved community, our ancestors before us, and the community of today. We are now at over 360 noon prayer calls as the beloved community of MCCDC. This has been a time of seeking God, and it's also a time of growing together. Beloved community at MCCDC shows up in so many ways. We're grateful for the authenticity of our sharing at Bible study. I think also of our writer's ministry, where we pour out our hearts and write about it, and then share devotionals with the community of MCCDC, and beyond. Psalm 133 says, "How good and pleasant it is when God's people live together in unity." We find ways to grow as community, as we find ways to show up for each other and to love each other. This journey of the Sermon on the Mount has been inspired by the writings of Amy Jill Levine. And towards the end of her book, The Sermon on the Mount, she writes, "Please savor the Sermon on the Mount, the teachings of Jesus. Read the rest of the scriptures through its teaching, and let the texts inform one another. Then share your readings with your friends and your enemies. If you let the Sermon on the Mount be your guide, you will not only have one foot in the kingdom of heaven, but also be able to experience the kingdom in your life and in your heart." This is an incomplete message today for an incomplete series. We are called to bring heaven to earth for the rest of our lives. Every line, every verse in the Sermon on the Mount is an entry point into this foundational living. Heaven comes to earth when we have victory over bitter anger. When we direct that anger to productive justice work, heaven comes to earth. Heaven comes to earth when we love our neighbors with generosity and also our enemies. Heaven comes to earth when we practice our faith, not to impress others, but to love others. Heaven comes to earth when we find treasure, not in stuff, but in lasting values. Heaven is both internal and external, within us and among us. When we live the Sermon on the Mount day after day, our lives are characterized by daily transformation. Ultimately, the Sermon on the Mount is not simply an 8-week worship series. Rather, it is a way to live for the rest of our lives. And by rest of our lives, I mean two things: the remainder of our lives, and lives that are marked by a sense of purposeful rest as we live with blessed connection and deep trust. So let us choose to live for the remainder of our lives, for the rest of our lives, with a sense of trust in God and the support of beloved community. We are so grateful that heaven comes to earth, not down the road, but now. So let us bring heaven to earth every day as we live lives that flourish, built on the solid foundation. Amen and amen.
Shadows deepen, Lord, with me abide. When other helpers fail and comforts flee, help of the helpless abide with.
We come to a time of communion, a time of sharing table around the world. Let us pray. Gracious God, God, take these gifts and make them be what you would have them to be in us, so that we might be for the world love and peace and joy. Amen. story of Christ around table, around breaking bread and lifting cup that is blessed and holy. We would like you to participate in communion, participate in this time of sharing. We'd like you also to take a look at a video that was created with sharing communion, breaking bread, lifting cup from around the world with our greater MCC community. At the end of that video, where the child is accepting communion, we would like to invite each of us to receive communion.
Thank you. daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever.
So much for making MCCDC a part of your Memorial Day weekend if you live in the States. For those of you that live around the world, we're just glad that you're a part of our world from wherever you are today. As we go through our lives, I invite us each day to bring heaven to earth. Heaven comes every time we lean into trust, and heaven comes every time we do our part to create beloved community. Go and bring heaven to earth every day in the name of God our Creator, Jesus Christ our Savior, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.